Hi, welcome to Spy Money. I'm going to talk to you about the SpyBot trend indicator. And this trend indicator, what it looks for is chop in longs and shorts. If you see the yellow, then that means stay out because it's chop. If it's in the red, that means a short, and blue is a long. You're going to still have some fake outs through here, but for the most part, it works pretty good. On this one, if you'd got in on this long, you would have got in somewhere around 63. And it kept on going. If you know, if you see one or two bars, ignore and just keep on going. But on this particular one, you probably would have got out and rolled through here, so that would have picked you up about 3 points or so. But you also could have got out, you know, if you set it for, most people trade ES, and that's what this is. We'll try to go for 2 to 5 points on ES on a movement. So on this particular one, if you got in around 63, that got up to 70. So you would have got your full 5 points right there. And then you could have waited on the next pullback. And as soon as it turned yellow, you could be looking for either a long or a short. And it turned out it was another long. So you could have got in and, you know, picked up some more points there. On the shorts, it does the same thing. You know, you get in here, it's roughly 60. You come down, you know, it's roughly 6-7 points that you could have gotten there. So if you had it set on a 5-point ATM strategy and picked that up, then you would have got those points. If you come back through, you can see that there is a lot of chop here, and it's keeping you out of that. Now, this is not 100% foolproof. Just as well as you can see here, it got you in a short and then took off. But if you're a trader, you're going to know that if you're in all this chop, you're probably going to wait until it breaks out of it. And if you look back through, you got your trend, you got your channel coming through here, and then back through here. So you know this is range, so you're probably not going to get in anyway. This is a very good visual. It's good for people that either just get tired of trying to chart out. They can just look at this and pretty well tell, you know, if you should be in long or short. The yellows, like I said, on this one, you stay out. If we come back and look back through here, you can see there's a lot of trades in here that you could have got in, picked up your points. Now, if you are a scalper like myself, and let's say you go back to like a 200, and then you can see this one would have got you in at 72, and they got you out at 74, 75 is the high. When I'm scalping, I'm looking anywhere from 2 to 5 points. Preferably, if I can get a couple points out of it, I'm perfectly content with that. I would rather get 2 points several times a day as get, you know, 5 points one time with the, you know, because I want in and out. So on this one, you would have turned red there. That's 73.25. It gets down to 71. So you would have got your 2 points there. So you would have got 2 points here, not there. This turned blue, but you know not to get in because it's lower than that up there. So I wouldn't have got in there. But, you know, for the most part, this does a really good job keeping you out of that chop and to allow you to get into these bigger trades. And if you look back through here, you can see that, you know, like on this one, you would have got in 71. It got you out at 73.25, so you got your 2 points there. It come back, and then it hit here again. So you'd be at 72.50, and it went all the way up to 75, so you would have got your 2 points there as well. So there's 4 points you could have got pretty easy off of that one. And you can also use this for like the seconds, the minutes, the range, whichever. It works really well to, even like on a 1 minute time frame, it does really well. So a lot of people trade the 1 minute, and it does real well for that as, you know, as well. But you can see there, this was Friday, there was a lot of chop, and if we come back and go through, we'll just pick something in here. You can see I'm not looking for anything particular time, but you know, you can see that one, and then right through here, there's a lot of chop. When you start seeing that's just back and forth, you're better off to stay out. This really helps you as far as in your trading to know when to get in and get out. And if you're, you know, on a lower time frames, if you're looking for 2 to 5 points, it makes it a little bit easier to get those points. If we go to NQ, it does the same thing. You know, it's really good about picking up those long spots with NQ. NQ is somewhat hard to trade because it moves so fast, and a lot of people will just stay away from it because of that. With this trend indicator, it actually helps you as far as knowing that there's chop here, and then boom, it hit the red, and so you could have picked up, there's 348 all the way down to 321. So there's roughly 27 points that you could have got. 27 points is $540 per contract. So that's really well. You can use this on micros too. So if you want to go to the MNQ, it works the exact same way. You can use it on any indicator you want or instrument. RTY is a really good one. This is Friday. If you had had this turned on, look at that. You could have got from right there, it's 39.7 all the way up to 46.7. So there's 7 points you could have got on that. There's $350 a contract with RTY. It would have kept you out there, and then it would have got you in a short here at 42. It went all the way down to 25. So that's going to be, 15, 17, about 17 points you could have got there as $340 a contract. So, it's more than that. 17 and 5, that's going to be, I can't do my math. I'm catching myself off guard. 17, 5 is, whatever that is, 850, I think it is. Correct me if I'm wrong. But the points that you can get on this is just incredible. And back again, during the daytime that Friday, we had a lot of chop. So when you're seeing all this, you know to kind of stay out. You could have picked up little small scalps on this at 20. That one's 39.5. It went all the way down to 36.7 or 36.6. So you could have picked up roughly 2.5-3 points right there. So that would have been a good deal for you. In the chop, if you just stick to smaller amounts, then you can pick up those, 1 to 3 points. Even as well as here, we got in there, it's 36.9. It went all the way down to 30. So you could have got a point, which would not have been great. Probably wouldn't have been worth it. You might have lost on that. But when you start looking at it overall and you start trading with it, you'll see that it actually works pretty good for you. A lot of good scalps in there on the 1 minute. If you go to like a 200 tick on this, you can see that you're going to make a lot more money doing the 200 tick. There's a lot more availability in there for picking up a point here and there. And so it actually works really well. Again, it works with all of the instruments. I typically do ES a lot. I like ES. I understand it. I do a lot of options with ES as well. So if you have any questions, let me know, and look forward to talking to you.